In this tutorial, I'll talk about how you can crop an image and how you can add it to your Canvas page as a banner. At Bellevue College, we're fortunate because we have a Canvas integration with a tool called City Labs. City Labs is a design tool that works with Canvas, and there's a lot of information about using City Labs on the Bellevue College e-learning website, and I'll be talking about it more in a future recording. I just mention it now because at this time, that if you're listening to this recording and you're using Canvas at another institution, that some of the tools that I talk about, they may not be available for you. So to get started with cropping and modifying an image in our Canvas Learning Management System at Bellevue College, we want to go to the page that we want to work with. We're going to want to choose the plugin tool along the toolbar. Then you're going to need to select the Upload and Embed Images tool. If you don't see it towards the top like I have it in my screen here, then scroll down and you should see it along in the menu options. Select Upload and Embed Image, and that brings up the cropping and formatting image tool. We have two image libraries from which we can select our graphics. These are similar but different libraries with images that faculty can use for educational purposes. So you have a variety of libraries that you can choose from, and you aren't required to, but if you're inclined, you can give credit to the photographer. I would probably do so like at the bottom of your page, of your Canvas page, but you can choose if you want to give credit, and you can choose how you want to give credit. So here's an image that's 3,200 by 2,400, and let's pretend that I want to use that one for my class. So once I select it, the first thing that the libraries do is that they reduce the size so it's a manageable width and height. Here it is, 1,100 by 825. Then in order to crop the image, we select the crop tool from our Upload and Embed Image tool set. And then we can choose the image width and height, or we can do a ratio. And for Canvas, the image ratio that's recommended is 10 by 3. Another tip is that we can continue to move it around to adjust what's going to be in the image, as you see that I'm doing here. We can also adjust the width and the height, so it's going to retain that ratio of 10 by 3 in this case, but we can change the content that it will show. Then we select Crop Image, and we want to then add a alt or alternative text to our image for a description. Then we will add it to our page. And then after we add the image in by using this tool, then Canvas does a very useful thing for us. It automatically sets this so it's proportional when we reduce the size of the browser windows. So that just means that if you view this using a mobile device, the image will still look clean, just as it does on a laptop or a desktop machine. And then finally, if you would like to use your own image from your own device, you certainly can. Here's an image that I have of some ducks on a river that I took, and then I can choose to crop it proportionally. And notice that I can crop it at 10 by 3, but you can use other ratios. So sometimes I'll do it at 10 by 2 to use up a little less real estate just on the page. Whatever works for you and your page, you can of course crop it as square as well, or other rectangle sizes. And then you add it into your page, and always be sure to add a alternative text description to that image. And that's how you can crop an image using Canvas.